Hello everyone, my name is Pooja Kadam and I am Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department of our college. Today I will be giving you a brief overview of the institute level elective Environmental Management, which is offered by Mumbai University for all the branches of engineering in the final year for semester 8. So what is Environmental Management? Environmental Management is a dynamic and emerging concept which is concerned with monitoring the impact a business is causing on its natural surroundings. Basically, environmental management acts to safeguard nature from potentially damaging business operations, constructing a win-win situation benefiting the economy and the environment. So what are the course outcomes? Basically, course outcomes means what you as student would be able to do at the end of the course. So at the end of the course, you will be able to illustrate the significance of environment management and sustainable development. You will be able to identify global environmental concerns and hazards. You will be able to employ the concept of ecology and interdependence between ecosystem and living organisms. You will be able to utilize the knowledge of scope of environment management and corporate environment responsibility. You will be able to outline the EMS certification and ISO 14000, and you will be able to interpret environment-related legislations and acts. So the syllabus of environmental management consists of 6 modules. The first module is on introduction and definition of environment management. The second is on global environmental concerns. The third is on concept of ecology. The fourth is on scope of environment management. The fifth is on ISO 14000 and EMS certification, and the sixth module is on overview of major legislations. Basically, the subject does not have practical and tutorial. It has 3 hours of theory lectures in a week. It does not have term work, oral and practical. It has internal assessment, test 1 and test 2, an average of 20 marks, and NSIM examination of 80 marks for 3 years. So in total, the subject carries 100 marks. Importance of environmental management. The past few decades have seen growing realization that the present model of development is unsustainable. The current generation, in the process of satisfying their basic needs and enjoying a better quality of life, is going to deprive the future generations of quality of life. The increasing stress we put on resources and environmental systems such as water, land, and air cannot go on forever, especially as the world population continues to increase. There is still time to avoid the worst impacts of climate change if strong corrective actions are started without further loss of time. Today, each and every country needs to realize the gravity of the situation. As a starting point, every nation should have a policy for environmental protection and sustainable development. So what are the role of engineers in environment management? The role of engineers in saving environments and affecting the sustainable development is very important because the engineers can use creativity, technology, and scientific knowledge to solve practical problems. Engineers should seek to minimize adverse impacts on the environment during the phases of development. Most projects require extensive environmental input. This will normally be in the form of environmental impact assessments and environmental surveys. Engineers are key facilitators in these relationships, mechanizing and optimizing the flows of valuable resources into human society and accelerating or moderating the damage done to nature. This realization has driven various attempts by engineers and other professionals to employ sustainable development in practice. Career in environment management and job profiles. If you are naturalist and want to put efforts for the betterment of the environment, then you must consider pursuing this field of study. Specialists in one of the particular areas of environment management can start their career as environmental managers. Some of the most approachable job titles are environmental professional, environmental auditor, environmental property assessor, and environmental systems manager. There are other interdisciplinary jobs that environmental managers can get as well. Environmental management students can also work in NGOs. There are plenty of opportunities around, but they will only rise as time passes by. The global environmental situation isn't just alarming, it is downright nerve-chilling. The polar ice caps are melting, sea levels are rising, winters are hot and summers are cold. Future prospects of environmental management jobs are undeniably good. In regards to its multidisciplinary nature, environmental management includes a diverse set of groups. For example, academics, policymakers, non-government organization workers, company employees, and civil servants. This multidisciplinary nature also means that its practice includes both you and me. Our actions, along with every other human on this planet, have some sort of environmental impact. These are a few of the references which are mentioned in the syllabus of your subject. So what exactly is environmental management? Is it a single field or discipline? Is it a process? Is it an agreed approach? Is it efforts to identify and pursue goals? Or is it environment and development problem solving? In a general sense, you could say that environmental management is the management of human impacts on the environment. Thank you so much. Okay, so that was all which I had shown in the orientation also. So I hope you must have seen that orientation before also, as well as now it just becomes a revision for you all. Okay, so our first module of environmental management is on basic introduction of environmental management, and I will also let you know what are the different, career prospects, okay, in environmental management. Just a second. I hope every one of you must have joined the Google Classroom of EM. Whoever has not joined it, do join, okay? In the all the IAM exam, everything would be there, all the notices regarding all the notes that I have. Okay, yes. In the syllabus, the reference books names are also given. I will check with our library because the physical classroom might start in this semester. Okay, so don't know when, but it might start. So I will once check in our library what books are there. Or else I do have notes regarding it. Whatever notes I have, whatever I am searching for, okay, that everything I will post it on the Google Classroom. Okay, so you can refer that also. Okay, so we will start with the introduction of the environmental management. Just a second. So what is environmental management? Environmental management is concerned with the man-environmental interface. Now, the various people have given different definitions. So here is one definition, that is environmental management is concerned with the man-environmental interface. Because we are developing, correct? We are developing the society. So of course, our act should not impact the environment, correct? So environmental management is concerned with the man-environmental interface, the complex boundary where biophysical and social cultural systems interact. Okay, where the social culture and biophysical, these things, the factors interact. Okay, then another definition of environmental management is, it is an approach which goes beyond natural resource management to encompass the political and social as well as the natural environment. It is an attempt to control human impact on and the interaction with the environment in order to preserve the natural resources. That's the same thing in the end of the orientation that we have seen, that in simple sense, what is environmental management? That is, it is an attempt to control the human impact on and the interaction with the environment in order to preserve the natural resources. Okay? Because we for development are using various natural resources. So in order to preserve that natural resources, how you will modify your way of development. Okay. Environmental management associated issues. Okay, when you talk of environmental management, of course we are supposed to, manage the various issues, various environmental issues. Okay, while you're biodevelopment is going on. Okay, so environmental management issues are the ecologic, earth science, atmospheric science, water science, climate change, society and culture, environmental law, environmental assessment, mitigating and monitoring, management practice, waste management, sustainability, ecology. Okay, so these are all the factors that you should keep in mind, because these are the associated issues. When you are thinking of environmental management, you are supposed to take into account all these issues in your development process. Okay. Characteristics of environmental management. It deals with the world affected by human. It supports sustainable development. It demands multidisciplinary approach. It has to integrate different developmental points of view. Now see here, sustainable development. It is a Venn diagram. So it is the mutual of, you know, when you talk about sustainable development, it has to be variable. It has to be environmental friendly. It has to be viable, that needs to be possible. Equitable, that is equal for all, beneficial for everyone. It should social, that is, it should be for the society, betterment of the society, and it should be economic. When you talk about sustainable development, okay, so it not just that, not just money or not just benefiting the society, okay, and not just, you know, whether it is possible, doable or not, viable in the sense, whether it is doable or not. When you talk about sustainable development, you are supposed to inculcate all these things. Economically, economic-wise, equitable, social, variable, environment, viable. All these factors are need to be considered when you talk about sustainable development. Then, characteristics of environmental management. It is applied for both short-term and long-term concerns. Integration of natural and social sciences. Integration of policy making and planning. So all the factors like social impact, environmental impact, economic impact, all these factors you need to consider. Then, significance of environmental management to prevent and solve the environmental problem. Very basic, right? Significance of environmental management. So to prevent and solve the environmental problems, to develop research and monitoring, to warn threats and identify opportunities. Of course, you know, now when you see there are threats, we come across a lot of opportunities. Okay, so to warn threats and identify opportunities, to suggest measures to resource conservation for long-term or short-term sustainable development, and to develop a strategy to solve the environmental issues. So these are the significance of environmental management. Okay, this is orientation of the path. Now at this stage, when you have affected the environment so much, okay, so you know, it, of course it has affected the environment, and it has now created a lot of career opportunities in that field. Okay, because we require people who can do the development by managing the environment. Okay, so now that has become the top priority throughout the world, not just our country, it is throughout the world. General scheme for environmental management, identification of objectives and defining the problem, determination of appropriate action plan, implementation and progress evaluation, monitoring and adjust management, future environmental management and planning. So this is a general, you know, path that is followed in environmental management. Then, approaches for of environmental management. There are three approaches of environmental management. First is a spatial approach, then you have ecological approach, then you have environmental management system approach. Okay, so when you talk about spatial approach, the spatial approach, that is the scope of your development or the approach, sorry, scope of managing the environment. Okay, so spatial approach is considered the management of environment at three levels: local level, regional level, and global level. Okay, when you are thinking of a development and when you are thinking of the environmental management at particular scope, whether it is at the local level or the regional level or the global level, so that is called the spatial approach. At global level, the spatial dimension and management strategies may be chopped out on the basis of needs, aspirations, perceptions, priorities, and innovations of the individuals, society, and government. Then, Next is an ecological approach, correct? So when you talk about ecological approach, it consists of two things, conservation and preservation, okay? Conserving and preserving. Reducing the usage and preserving whatever is left, whatever you have, okay? The ecological approach considers the management of ecological resources to save the environment. It has two methods to manage ecology. The first is conservation, that is to utilize the natural environment for social needs, but a simultaneous effort to maintain the ecological balance. You are not going to use the resources too much, that they are not left itself. Okay, they are not even left for your next generations. Okay, so conservation, that is utilize the natural environment for social needs, but a simultaneous effort to maintain the ecological balance. The next is in ecological approach, the next is preservation, that is to save some species or natural environment from social utilization in order to protect them. Okay, that is preserving. So ecological approach has two things, that is conservation and preservation. The environment management system approach. Okay, there are three approaches, right? The spatial approach we have seen, ecological approach, and EMS, that is environmental management system approach. Now, environmental management system has been defined by ISO 14001 as this ISO 14000 and everything, you have a different module as well. Okay, so EMS has defined by ISO 14000 as the part of the overall management system that includes organizational structure, planning activities, responsibilities, practices, procedures, processes, and resources for developing, implementing, achieving, and reviewing the environmental policy. Okay, so that is the environmental management system approach. That is a part of the overall management system. Okay, the overall management system jo hota hai, koi bhi particular say company ka. Okay, so a part of it that includes organizational structure, planning activities, responsibilities, practices, procedures, processes, resources for developing, implementing, achieving, and reviewing the environmental policy. Okay, but everything that happens in the company or that industry, but for implementing, for developing, implementing, achieving, and reviewing the environmental policy. That is the environmental management system approach. Then elements of EMS, elements of environmental management system, kya kya hai? So there are four elements, that is act, plan, do, and check. Okay, when you talk about act, it is the management review, implement corrective actions, and improvement. Okay, when you talk about plan, it is environmental policies, objectives and targets, legal register, significant aspects and impacts. When you talk about do, okay, it is procedures, document, control, training and communication. When you talk about check, it is internal monitoring and auditing and reporting the results. So that are the four elements of environmental management system. Okay. What EMS does, environmental management system, what it does, it brings together the people, policies, plans, review, mechanism, procedures that are used to manage the environmental issues at a facility or in an organization or in a company, okay? So it is the system that brings together people, policies, plans, review, mechanisms, and procedures used to manage the environmental issues. That is called the environmental management system. What EMS does? It facilitates the environmental compliance. Environmental compliance means the consent. Okay. So it facilitates the environmental compliance. It addresses the environmental impacts. It broadens the environmental responsibilities to all those whose work can have significant impact on the environment. Correct. Whenever you are thinking of environmental management system, first of all, it is what all things are there in your organization that are compliance with the environmental factors. They are in consent with the environmental factors. Then what are the issues? What are the impacts? Okay, due to your organization, so addressing those environmental impacts and broadens, that is broadening the environmental responsibilities whose work is actually affecting the environment. Workflow of EMS is a continuous process of plan, implement, check, review, plan, implement, check, review. It's a continuous process. And framework or environmental management system. Okay, so you have ISO 14000 standard. It's a standard policy that needs to be followed, that we will see in the further module. Code of Environmental Management Principles, Compliance Focused Environmental Management System, Eco Management and Audit Scheme. So ISO 14001 is a family of standards related to environmental management that exists to help the organization minimize how their operations negatively affect the environment, comply with the applicable laws and regulations and other environmentally oriented requirements, and continually improve in the above. Okay, so these are the actually various standards of environmental management. Okay, based on that standards, your development has to be based. Okay. And components of ISO 14001 are environmental policy, planning, implementation and operation, checking and corrective action, management review. Okay, so the same components of the environmental management system, oh, sorry, it's of the ISO 14001, the same component that we have seen, okay, here. These are shown in the flow diagram. That is, when you talk about first environmental policy, then planning, that is the environmental aspects, compliance with the environmental factors, objectives and targets, environmental management programs, okay, that is the planning. Then implementation, that is roles and responsibilities, training and communication, EMS document control, emergency preparedness and response, those things come under implementation. Then checking and corrective action, this measurement and monitoring, EMS non-conformance and corrective actions, records, EMS audits, that is checking and corrective action, and then the management review. Okay, and then from the management review, again the environmental policy is revised. Okay, accordingly, again then you have planning, implementation, checking, and then management review. And according to the management review, again you will have to change the environmental policy. Okay, depending upon how you know how the impact is has reduced. Okay, accordingly you have to, the environmental policy will differ, and then again you will have to change your actions. So that is a continuous improvement process. So what is environmental policy? An environmental policy is a statement about an organization's environmental position and values. The ISO 14001 standard states that an environmental policy is the organization's overall environmental performance, intentions, and direction formally expressed by the top management. Okay, जैसे हम लोग कॉलेज का, हम लोग इंस्टीट्यूट का विजन बोलते हैं एक. Okay, vision we have. Okay, basically in that environmental policy is also a statement that is made by the organization to just show, you know, show that how well is your organization at the environmental position, how well it is following the rules of the, how well it is following those standards of ISO 14000. Okay, 14001. So that is the environmental policy. Environmental policy features. It is issued with a policy statement signed by the facility manager. At a minimum, it commits to continual improvement, pollution prevention, environmental compliance. It identifies the EMS framework. It is publicly available. This actually, this diagram is so good and very nice to understand. Okay, we have moved to green, we have moved to organic. All those are, you know, have to be the fruits of the same tree. without affecting the environment. We have seen development, correct? And you know, recycle, reuse the see here, you can see the windmill also shown here. Okay, actually this diagram is very good. Okay, so how every individual environmental factor needs to be balanced. Environmental planning is a decision making process. Okay, planning हम लोग बोल रहे हैं. तो ऑफ कोर्स इट्स अ डिसीजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस दैट कंसीडर्स द एनवायरमेंटल सोशल पॉलिटिकल इकोनॉमिक एंड गवर्नेंस फैक्टर्स दैट कैन इफेक्ट डेवलपमेंट. इट्स गोल इज टू मैनेज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन नेचुरल सिस्टम्स एंड ह्यूमन सिस्टम्स इन द प्रेजेंट एंड द फ्यूचर. ओके, दैट्स द एनवायरमेंटल प्लानिंग, करेक्ट? व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू इम्प्लीमेंट समथिंग, द इनिशियल स्टेज इज प्लानिंग, सो दैट इज द डिसीजन मेकिंग. Features of environmental planning: it identifies aspects and impacts from facility activities, products and services, review legal requirements, set objectives and targets, establish formal EMS program. That are the features of environmental planning. Scope of environmental management: the awareness regarding environmental problems and their proper management began in 1970s through various people movement around many countries of the world. The Greenpeace movement, the Chipko movement, etc. are some of them. The advancement in the field of science and technology helped to provide various tools and instruments supported by statistical data to properly solve environmental problems and help in its management. Okay, so that was just a brief introduction of the environmental management. Okay, just a second. A few more things which are included in environmental management system, or not system, we'll say basically the environmental management one. Few more things, because their first one is all about the introduction and the career aspects of the environmental management. So the few more things related to it we will see. Okay. कंसेप्ट ऑफ सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट ऑलरेडी हमने प्रीवियस इसमें देखा था कि सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट क्या है. ओके, वही यहाँ पे भी दिया है. सी हियर द सिटीज एंड कम्युनिटीज, व्हेन यू आर हियर इट्स द सिटीज एंड कम्युनिटीज अ बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ फॉर ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द सोसाइटी, लॉन्ग टर्म एनवायरमेंटल प्रैक्टिसेस. ओके, देन बिजनेस प्रैक्टिसेस विद लो एनवायरमेंटल इम्पैक्ट्स. Economic development combined with sustainable transport system bringing solid economic growth. Okay, social inclusion bringing economic prosperity. Okay, so that is economy, environment and society, all things you need to consider when you think about sustainable development. So it is a pattern of resource use that aims to meet human needs while preserving the environment, so that these needs can be met not only in the present but also for the generations to come. The development initiatives can be initiated in such a way that the future generations can enjoy the benefits of nature without any compromise. Sustainable development is a development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of the future generations to meet their own needs. Okay, so that is your sustainable development. Okay. Environment management, क्या है ये हमने ऑलरेडी देखा था. तो एट द ग्लोबल स्केल एंड इन द ब्रॉडेस्ट सेंस एनवायरमेंटल मैनेजमेंट इन्वॉल्व द ओशन द फ्रेश वाटर सिस्टम द लैंड द एटमोस्फियर बट फॉलोइंग द सस्टेनेबिलिटी प्रिंसिपल ऑफ स्केल इट कैन बी इक्वली अप्लाइड टू एनी इको सिस्टम फ्रॉम अ ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट टू अ होम गार्डन. सो एनीथिंग दैट कम्स इन योर एनवायरमेंट इट कैन बी अप्लाइड टू एनीथिंग. ओके, concept of environmental management, it is an attempt to control human impact on an interaction with the environment in order to preserve the natural resources. This we have seen, correct? Environment management focuses on improvement of the human welfare for present and future generations. Administrative functions that develop, implement and monitor the environmental policy of an organization. Environment management implies not only a mere management of environment, but it is essentially the management of various activities with intolerable constraints imposed by the environment itself and with full consideration of ecological factors. Thus, it involves environmental planning, conservation of resources, environmental status evaluation, and environmental legislature and administration. Now, characteristics of environment management, we have seen the previous slide also. It deals with the world affected by humans. It supports sustainable development. It demands multidisciplinary approach. It has to integrate different development viewpoints. The time scale involved extends the short-term and concern ranges from local to global. It seeks to integrate natural and social science, policy making and planning. This environmental management implies an implement of conscious choice from a variety of alternative proposals, and furthermore that such a choice involves purposeful commitment for recognized and desired objectives. Okay, so when even in the smallest, like I have given you an example that you look after energy efficient things, you look after organic things now. Okay, you look after green technology. Even in the smallest thing, you look after green technologies. Okay, so that is also a part of environmental management. Now, these definitions we have already seen in the previous slide also. That is the definition of environmental management. Only one more definition here is given, that it's a generic description of a process undertaken by systems-oriented professionals with a natural science, social science, or less commonly, an engineering, law, or design background. See, very important engineering background as well. Okay, an engineering, law, or design background. Tackling problem of human-altered environment on an interdisciplinary basis from a quantitative and or futuristic viewpoint. Some other definition is the process of allocating natural and artificial resources so as to make optimum use of the environment in satisfying the basic human needs at the minimum and more if possible on a sustainable basis. Throughout the world, particularly in developing countries, there is an urgent need for the management of total environment. In the first instance, environment management must do three things: identify goals, establish where this can be met, and develop and implement means to do what it deems possible. This few significance of environmental management, also we have seen that it's an approach which integrates ecology, policy making, planning and social development. Its main objectives are as follows, that is to prevent and solve the environmental problems, to establish the limits, to develop research institutions and monitoring systems, to warn threats and identify opportunities, to suggest measures for resource conservation, to develop a strategy for the improvement of quality, to suggest long-term and short-term policies for sustainable development, and to identify new technology for future development. This same significance of the environmental management we have seen in the previous slide as well. It was the same. Same. It's the general scheme that I have already told you of the environmental management. That is identifying the objective and defining the problem, determining determination of the appropriate action plan, implementation and progress evaluation, monitoring and adjust management, and future environmental management and planning. So that's the stepwise process you have to follow in an environmental management. When you talk about environmental management in a particular organization. Now, what are the different trends in environmental management? Impact assessment and planning, IAP. So that is assessing the environmental and social impact prior to setting up operations and obtaining environmental approval from the authorities is almost mandatory in most project categories. So IAP, that is the impact assessment and planning. Okay, it may be required not only for newly constructed facilities, but also for new operations that will be housed in an existing building. Okay, so it is the assessing impact assessment and planning. The word itself says it, right? That is assessing the environmental and the social impacts prior to setting up any operation. Okay. Then, environmental liability and cleanup. So that is foreign investment has resulted in a heightened scrutiny of current and historic environmental liabilities associated with the property transactions in India. Then sustainability and regulatory compliance, that is increasing desire of Indian companies to meet the world-class standards has caused established companies in India to take on sustainability initiatives as a means of improving their global brand and reputation. So these are various trends that are now followed when you talk about environmental management. What are the different initiatives, environmental initiatives taken in India? There is the National Council for Environmental Policy and Planning was set up in 1972, which was later evolved into Ministry of Environment and Forest, that is the MOEF, in 1985. Then MOEF and the Pollution Control Board, the CPCB, that is the Central Pollution Control Board, and the SPCB, that is the State Pollution Control Board, together form the regulatory and administrative core of the sector. In the policy statement for abatement of pollution and the national conservation strategy and policy statement on environment and development were brought out by MOEF, that is the Ministry of Environment and Forest, in 1992. Then the EAP, that is the Environmental Action Program, which was formulated in 1993 with the objective of improving the environmental services and integrating the environmental considerations into development programs. So these are few of the initiatives that have taken that we have taken in our country, keeping into mind the environment management. Then for the protection of the environment, further continuing, okay, for the protection of the environment and to control the pollution, several measures have been undertaken both by the government and the NGOs. Even before independence, some laws have been enacted for the protection of the environment. In the Indian Penal Code of 1860, the Article 268, 290, 291, 426, 430, 431, and 432 are all related with the environment. Similarly, the Article 277, which was related with the water pollution, and 278 is related with the air pollution. The National Environmental Policy 2006. It is the first initiative in strategy formulation for environmental protection in a comprehensive manner. It undertakes a diagnosis of the causative factors of land degradation with a view to flagging the remedial measures required in the direction. It recognizes that the relevant fiscal, tariffs, and sectoral policies need to take explicit account of the unintentional impacts on land degradation. As the quality of life improves, demand for better quality services and products also increases, correct? Customers all over the world and at all times demand that they be assured and satisfied with the product and services as anticipated, correct? As expected. However, inspection is not a satisfactory way of giving assurance that the product will perform as desired during its life. It is generally agreed that the required level of the quality can be built into the product only through use of a proper quality management system. Now we had seen certain initiatives that are taken in our country in related to environmental management. Similarly, you have initiatives taken at global level as well. Okay. Related to this global initiatives, we will see in our tomorrow's lecture. We will continue this from